So, the Marvel Cinematic Universe's Phase 4 has been kind of a bummer. I know most people have thought that Phase 4 overall has been a lot worse, but I strongly dislike most of the projects. WandaVision had, like, a fantastic first three episodes, but then lost its charm as it started to, like, explain its mystery. And then Falcon and the Winter Soldier, it had some cool action, like a good Sam Wilson arc, and some really, really bad villains. And then there's Loki. I mean, I respect it for having a, like, fully fleshed out arc for the protagonist that, like, makes some actual logical and emotional sense, but, like, I feel they completely changed the entire core of Loki. Instead of having the god of mischief, a trickster, and a backstabber, we have a Loki without edge, cunning, and the unpredictability that made him a fan favorite. And then we had Black Widow, the first movie of Phase 4. I mean, it was cool when it was a family spy movie, but it was really, really bad when it was an MCU superhero film. But at least, you know, Yelena is pretty good, but if it wasn't in a superhero universe, I think I'd love it. What If was fine, the animated faces were weird, the episodes were, like, all too short. They all felt like they had 10 minutes cut short, and I don't really care to see more. Then there's Shang-Chi and the Legend of the Ten Rings. Like, I was so excited for this movie. Had mind-blowing action and was just so bad, though. There's, like, so many useless side characters, a boring third act, and Awkwafina interrupting what should have been an actually interesting dramatic sacrifice. And, of course, Shang-Chi, like himself, he's a boring character with a muddied arc and zero defining character traits. So, just a big letdown for me. Then Eternals, I mean, it brings up, like, 5 million interesting philosophical questions and half, like, half answers, like, three of them. Like, yeah, it was pretty to look at, but wow, Gemma Chan Cersei is just like Shang-Chi and has zero chemistry with Icarus. And then we have Hawkeye, which is freaking amazing for 5 episodes and like decent for one more. It's my favorite Phase 4 project by far. I already have like 6 podcast episodes gushing about this, so I'm not gonna talk about it more. Spider-Man No Way Home had some incredibly amazing fun moments. It was emotional, nostalgic, and then you think about like the first 2 hours and you realize that Doctor Strange is really stupid, Peter acts like a star of a Disney Channel sitcom, and all of the story beats are like really stupid and messy. Then we have Moon Knight, which was just like an acting display for Oscar Isaac and not much else. Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness is like when you get like a boring prompt in English class, so you just write about something else instead and hope you get a good grade. Like, this should have been a Wanda movie, but Marvel doesn't want that. And instead we get America Chavez, a Hispanic plot device in a boring Doctor Strange arc. And then Miss Marvel, it was cool for about 4 minutes, but then they decided to like abandon all of the style and, you know, say no to a coming of age story. So we end up with a rushed narrative that makes very little sense. We spend like 4 hours with Kamala Khan, and I know a bunch about her family, her history, her like really weird origin and how she's like a mutant and stuff, but nothing about her personality traits, beliefs, and characteristics. So, you know, that's kind of like Marvel Phase 4 in a nutshell. Iman Vellani is like really good though. And then we have Thor Love and Thunder, which squanders like every good idea it has, like Jane Foster's cancer storyline, Thor's identity crisis, Gore's god philosophy, and like Valkyrie's king problems. Like, it tosses that all aside so we can just have a bunch of jokes and a bunch of hollow resolutions. So almost every single project in Phase 4 has felt like a frustrating slog, but I have hope for one project, Fantastic Four. Now, I've never really been a huge Fantastic Four fan. I didn't really read their comics until recently, but I love their family dynamic. Like, I love it. I love family dramas in general, and seeing that in a superhero context is really interesting. Reed Richards and Sue Storm are both fantastic characters. Ben Grimm has a super interesting struggle, and like watching the previous movies of Marvel's first family, like, man, I get so excited for what they could be. Like, both the 2005 and 2015 versions aren't great, but man, the potential that they have. They're a family that always protects each other. They're scientists, they're innovators, they're trailblazers. They explore the galaxies in search of anything that can help humanity. But they're also like heroes that do everything for the good of mankind. And there's like so much good content in there. And for Kevin Feige and Marvel Studios, I feel like they're going to get this right. It's attempt number 3 in like pop culture, and I have faith that they can get something good. So for fun, I want to cast this Fantastic Four movie. So this is my version. I'm pretending I'm Sarah Hallie Finn right now, going to cast the Fantastic Four. So I'm going to go through each of the four, talk about my views of the characters based on like the comics I've read, the movies, and also a little bit of Wikipedia, and go through some options. So first we have Reed Richards, Mr. Fantastic. Reed is a mad scientist. He's extremely curious and always seeks to learn, push forward, and discover the unthinkable. This is like his greatest strength. It makes him the smartest man in the world, and it creates incredible feats. But it's also his greatest weakness. His curiosity is this itch that never goes away, and he always wants to scratch it. And he has to. It often results in him neglecting his family, being reckless, and tampering with things he shouldn't. Still, he's a loving father in his own right. He's a leader, and he's someone who cares deeply about the people around him. He is always doing what's good for humanity, and he has a big picture vision of what needs to be done, and he will do whatever he thinks is right to do so. He also doesn't listen to others because he thinks and knows that he's smarter and better than everyone else. He doesn't like it when there's something he can't understand. He's extremely smart and can easily detach himself from reality. He can bury himself in his work for days at a time, and he can seem really distant. So my read, he needs to have a little bit of darkness to him to be able to show that burden of knowledge and the world weighing on his shoulders. He needs to look intelligent, thoughtful, and toe the line between like a well-meaning person and also a bit of a jerk. I'm looking for maybe a guy in his mid-30s to early 40s, enough runway to be the cornerstone of the MCU, but enough age to be experienced and to command a team and respect from the rest of the world. John Krasinski, he could probably be Reed, but he's probably a little bit too hunky, and I don't think he has that range to have that distance troubled scientist vibe going on. Then there's Dominic Raines. He's been on Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. and Chicago Med. He's very much a TV actor. He has that TV vibe. But I think he can portray a darkness and almost a little bit of a mystery that feels distant. He seems like a guy that people have like trouble figuring out and trouble getting to the core of. And he has a little bit of a softer voice that I think could work well. Then there's Rahul Kohli. I have no idea who this dude is. I might have butchered his name. And I've never seen him in anything. But apparently everyone loves him as Reed. And so there could be that. I don't know. But he looks a little too cool for, you know, like the smartest man in the world. And there's also Penn Badgley. He's a little bit on the younger side. I've heard good things about his performance in You. He definitely has that darker side because he's a creeper on that show. He has a side that looks to tinker, to keep pushing forward. I think he has that thoughtfulness look about him. He can definitely play that withdrawn, distant, like introverted part of Reed. But I'm not sure about like the leader and loving part. Joseph Gordon-Levitt is also someone who looks like a good choice. I don't even know if he'd want to commit to this kind of role for a long time. I mean, he's a great actor with a great amount of range. He's done a bunch of projects. I think he's someone who would be able to take an interesting spin on Reed. But my choice is a popular one. William Jackson Harper. Watch The Good Place and you'll basically see a sitcom version of Reed. I think he would nail this kind of love-hate relationship the audience should have with Reed. You love him for his heart and for his heart for people, his family, but you hate his tunnel vision, his restlessness. And Jackson Harper is endearing enough, but also quiet and curious enough to balance that well, I think. So William Jackson Harper as Reed Richards. Now we have Sue Storm, Invisible Woman. She is the heart of the team. She deeply understands people and can get through to them. She is warm, caring, responsible. She's motherly. And there's some problems, honestly, with her character. In the comics, she's very just sidelined to be Reed's girlfriend or wife. She's just like the mother, and that's about it. Like, she's stuck in the secondary housewife character, and a lot of her being in person is what she is in relation to other people. So in my version, where I kind of see Sue as, she has more agency, more life. And in the comics, she was, you know, pursuing an acting career. She was a great swimmer, and she's also very smart. But she had to give that up once her mom died and her dad turned into a deadbeat drunk. And she had to become a mother figure for her younger brother. So she had this great potential to do so much, to do literally anything in the world. She could have had fame, fortune, all of this and that, but she sacrificed that for her younger brother. And that's something that Johnny never really appreciated. So I want to explore a Sue that has sacrificed and maybe is even a little bit fed up with that sacrifice. She's torn between taking something for herself, finding happiness for herself, and continuing to be this loving, caring, thoughtful person that she has always been. More on this later, but let's talk about what I want in an actress for Sue. She needs to be warm. She needs to be empathetic. And she also needs to hold her own against others and be brave and bold and stand up to people when she needs to. She can take charge as well as a leader. She'll jump into action. And she also needs to be very mature. She is still this mother of this group. And William Jackson Harper, he's 42 years old, and he does look a little younger. So I'm looking for someone like around 35 to 40, just like a bit younger than my Reed. There's Jodie Comer. She's been killing it in Free Guy, The Last Duel, Killing Eve. She definitely has the range for Sue and can hold her own against other actors that she's been up against, like Ryan Reynolds, Matt Damon, Adam Driver, that kind of stuff. And also, I think she could do action very well. And then maybe, again, from Chicago Med, there's Yaya DaCosta. I think I can see her doing the warmth of Sue really well. Like, DaCosta has had her share of, like, angry outbursts on the show, but I don't think she really has that mature vibe for me. She might be a little bit too young for that. If this was in a totally different universe, when I was casting like a much younger Fantastic Four, I'd give like Daniela Melcher from the Suicide Squad a chance. She was great as Ratcatcher 2. You know, there's a lot of heart and emotion there. But she's going to be in Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3, probably as like a voice actor. So, I mean, we could cast her again. And I don't know. She's also going to be in Fast 10. So maybe she starts breaking out then. But I don't know. It'd be an interesting choice for like an alternate reality. And honestly, Ana de Armas, she could be good too. Her performance in Knives Out like oozes that kind heart and soul that Sue Storm is. But Sue is, she's bold, she's strong, and she's assertive when she wants to be, right? And maybe this is just her accent or like the way she says some words, but to me, Ana de Armas sounds a little soft and complainy when she tries to stand firm and be more explosive. So I don't really think she has the bite that's needed in order to handle like the egos of Reed, of Johnny, of Ben. And I can't really put my finger on why. And I think there's better options out there. But also, we talked about Penn Badgley earlier. From the show You, maybe Elizabeth Lyle. Like, if there was ever a Sue Storm come to life, it's her. She looks exactly what I'd imagine a real-life invisible woman to be. She's been in Once Upon a Time as Anna, so the mix of warmth and optimism and strength from Anna, and then maybe the kindness, the seriousness, and dramatic weight from Beck. So, I mean, I think that could be a great Sue Storm there. I also really, really like Dakota Johnson as Sue Storm. She's only 32, which is on the younger side, but man, she's great for Sue. Like, go watch Peanut Butter Falcon, and I see a perfect Sue Storm there. I really love that movie. She's like a caring mother figure who has a sweet smile and also shares so much care for others. But she's also like very willing to fight and stand firm. Like she is fighting all the time with Shia LaBeouf's character on what to do for the child. She wears a lot of like responsibility on her shoulders, and she's almost a little bit too uptight at sometimes. Plus she's, you know, been doing a lot of good indie work recently. She has a lot of credits to her name ever since, you know, the 50 Shades thing. She's a great actress across many different types of movies. And also, like, in real-life interviews, she just seems super, like, calming and kind and someone who can, like, get through to people. And sure, she's, like, Madame Web for Sony now, like, but we all know that's going to crash and burn, so maybe she could just take the jump over to the MCU. But anyways, my choice has to go to Chantel Van Santen. Like, yeah, I know it's a little unorthodox, a little bit out of nowhere. She doesn't really do much. But man, I totally see Patty Spiffin from The Flash as a younger version of, like, a possible Sue. She's driven, she's bold, she's unafraid, she's brave, and we see her be vulnerable and softer with Barry as well. And yeah, she's a TV actress, but she is a seasoned veteran with For All Mankind, FBI, and I have confidence that she would do well and like fit nicely next to William Jackson Harper. So, Chantel Van Santen as Sue Storm. Now, Sue's younger brother, Johnny Storm, the Human Torch. He's charming, playful, sexy. He's impulsive, he's irresponsible, and he has a short fuse. He has a quick temper. He's carefree, immature, he's a jokester, but underneath that, he does really care about his family and his teammates. But he needs attention, he needs praise, he wants to be acknowledged. He loves being in the spotlight, and he needs to be important and cool. He needs to be someone who's really good looking and charismatic. My actor, he needs to be someone who can put on this big, huge, almost larger than life persona, and he needs to be someone who's like uncomfortable with being vulnerable and his own insecurities. For Johnny, I think there's a bunch of white guys who could do this, but let's think outside the box a little bit. Maybe Diego Boneta? Know nothing about him, but he looks cool. Mina Massoud? I recently watched the live-action Aladdin, and he's charismatic enough, I think. Trevante Rhodes would crush this role, like, definitely, but I think he'd be much better for other roles in the MCU. Then there's Sam Claflin. He could be Johnny, but he's a little too old. And Zac Efron, he was born to play Johnny as well, but he's also a bit on the older side. He's 34. Glenn Powell would also be good, but again, 33, a little too old for my Sue Storm, who's 36 years old. So maybe Dacre Montgomery from Power Rangers and Stranger Things. He has the talent and the experience to be in a popular franchise. Like, if you watch him in Stranger Things, he's great. He could definitely be the douche, but like, also in a GQ video, he also said he's like not really interested in doing superhero movies. He's 27 years old, so a decent age range, but his face is like a little babyish. He doesn't look like the superstar celebrity that Johnny Storm wants to be. So my choice is Dylan O'Brien. He's 30 years old, which is a tad old, but he's still 6 years under Chantel. And you could shave his facial hair, and he looks super young. And he's a talent that's been around for a while, like Teen Wolf. He headed up the failed like Maze Runner series. He hasn't really broken into stardom yet. And he's got the charisma and the talent to do drama. I feel like it's easier to ham it up and be more jerky and douchey than it is to like deliver earnest, genuine emotion. And Johnny, he needs both. And he's not always going to be pouring his heart out, but he loves his family. He's willing to sacrifice everything for him, and he's super loyal. And in Love and Monsters, O'Brien is like effortlessly endearing. He's super lovable. And then also in the new movie that just came out on Hulu, Not Okay, he's douchey. He's a super cool influencer. So he's got them both. So Dylan O'Brien as Johnny Storm. Now for our last member of the Fantastic Four, Ben Grimm. I think he's super interesting. He's tough, loyal, and has a good heart. He grew up in a tough neighborhood, and he knows how to take a punch or a joke, and he's worked his way up. He became a great athlete, a great pilot, a smart man, and he had it all until he got turned into an ugly monster. He was given this curse while his other friends were given amazing abilities. It's like totally unfair. So he needs to be this brooding, negative, gruff man. He needs to be able to handle a good internal battle. He needs to have a flicker of hope that, like, it's destroyed over and over again, but he continues to come back, to stand up again. He needs to have this bitterness, like a lifelong anger that is waiting to explode. Also, it'd be cool if he was Jewish. He was based off of Jack Kirby himself, and he was one of the early Jewish characters, so I looked at mostly Jewish actors. Alden Ehrenreich, he could be good, but he's joining Ironheart. Ricky Whittle and John Boyega are both not Jewish, but they could be very interesting in the role. Like, I think Whittle did a great job in The 100, playing like a gruff guy whose humanity is slowly shown more and more. And then Boyega, he's talented too. I've watched Star Wars a few times. I think Ben Foster would be good. Saw him in The Hustle. We have Robert Kaczynski. He could be a good choice. He had a cameo as like an annoying biker in Captain Marvel, but who cares? It doesn't really matter. He has experience as a CGI voice character from Warcraft. I mean, he looks big. He's Jewish. Boom. That could be really nice. But my choice is going to be Patrick John Pfluger from Chicago PD. Chicago PD is by far the best Chicago show on NBC. And he has the voice, a gruff voice. And after watching a few seasons, I think he has good enough dramatic chops too. He can do like the boring soapy stuff on TV. But he has this real seriousness and weight to Ben. And he also plays like a likable, rootable character on PD, which is a huge part of Ben Grimm's story. Like, you have to feel for him. So, Patrick John Pfluger as Ben Grimm. So, there's my Fantastic Four cast. We have William Jackson Harper as Reed Richards, Chantel Van Santen as Sue Storm, we have Dylan O'Brien as Johnny Storm, and then Patrick John Pfluger as Ben Grimm. I think none of these guys are really high profile actors yet. I don't really think Kevin Feige is going to go with big name actors for Fantastic Four. I think the name of it and the Marvel Studios name will just like carry that movie anyways. And I'm really excited to see who they bring to these four roles. I think in D23, there's a good chance that we'll get a director and a cast for Fantastic Four. So I don't know. We'll see how this looks in a month. But yeah, here's my Fantastic Four. Kevin Feige, take notes. I will not get mad if you steal my casting decisions. So until next time, guys. Bye.